Finally, we have Altered Beast. I'll be doing three versions of the game in this episode. I have vague memories of my uncle playing this when I was about three, but the only Mega Drive games I cared about back then were his Sonic games. It wasn't until my dad's then-girlfriend's kids had one of those plug-and-plays shaped like a little Mega Drive that I got to try this out again. I'm starting with the original arcade version included as an unlockable on Sega Mega Drive Collection on the PS2. The game's story is very simple. I play as a warrior brought back from the dead by Zeus to rescue his daughter Athena from Neith, the ruler of the underworld. I can punch, kick, and jump. First off, there are a couple zombies that take 2 hits to kill, first to take their heads off and then the rest of them. The main thing I have to be looking out for are these flashing two-headed wolves. Killing one has it transform into an orb that powers up my warrior so much he bursts out of his shirt. Now the zombies die in one hit. There are also regular brown wolves that lunge at me, but they only give points when killed. The next enemy I meet are these skeletons who hold their own heads in their hands, and I get my second power up, which makes him ridiculously buff, but his head stays the same tiny size. I miss the third wolf as another new enemy, these big ogres, appear. This one stunlocks me and finishes me off. But this is an arcade re-release, so I have unlimited continues. So it doesn't even matter that he took out another full life right after. I also get a gargoyle fly down at me to get killed as I meet Neith, keeping me away with his magic. Since I haven't got all 3 power-ups yet, he just walks away and the level continues. I take out the very next wolf and get my final power-up for this level, a werewolf transformation. I can throw fiery hadoukens and do falcon kicks across the screen. All of these take out enemies in one hit. Every level has its own transformation, which is kind of the problem in that while the werewolf is not my favourite, it's the most fun to me and the easiest to use, and it's only the first one. I reach Neith, who transforms into the first boss, Agar. This giant brown Shrek throws multiple copies of his own head at once. I just have to keep throwing attacks out at him until he explodes. A portal opens up in the ground where Neff's head comes out to steal my power-ups. But he does give me my shirt back, so he's not irredeemable. I then jump down the portal after him and get to see an image of Neith getting Athena in a headlock. Level 2 is in some sort of swamp with these blob things that explode after a single kick. I get my first power-up as I run into these giant rattlesnakes. You can kill them by kicking their tails off before they leave the ground, otherwise you just have to hit their heads. The second flashing wolf jumps over me during this and I miss it. Following that are the cockatrices that will later show up as rideable animals in Golden Axe. I then miss another flashing wolf when it charges by from behind and kills me. I reach Neith, but since I have only one power-up, he ignores me. Not long after that I get my second power-up. I also get to show how dangerous the blobs can be if one reaches you, where one latches onto my head and takes away 2/3 of my health. Once again, I miss the next wolf since I was being too cautious from this section of level just sticking rattlesnakes everywhere. Thanks to this, Neith ignores me again, but right after I get a wolf that doesn't move so I can finally get my next transformation, a dragon. The dragon has free flight over the entire screen, and can even fire bolts of electricity from its hand or surround itself in electricity like Blanka. It's alright, but it's so long that it takes up more space on screen, making it easy to get hit and a little awkward to control. I'm finally good enough and have to pay attention to, and he transforms into the next boss, Octize. It's a giant plant monster shooting out many of its own eyes at me. I just have to zap the eyes that get close, and when I had the free time, keep shooting the main eye until it's defeated. Neith takes my power-ups again and I head deeper. This time we see Neith crucifying Athena while doing some sort of spell, but it also looks like he's bathing in that cauldron. Level 3 is in a cave with huge wasp men running from one side of the screen to the next. Once again I miss the white wolf. Another new enemy is these giant snails as I get my first power-up. I then miss the next when it kills me. So of course Neith wants nothing to do with me, and as usual I'm given a free one immediately after and miss the next one. Neith ignores me again and I get another free power-up, transforming me into a bear. It can turn enemies into stone and then destroy them with its somersault. It's not the easiest to play as, but its kung fu stance and walk animation with unflinching confidence makes it my favourite. This time Neith transforms into a whatever the fuck this is. I know it has a name, but nothing would fit the sheer confusion I feel when I look at it. It has these projectiles that move in a circular pattern, but I just ignore them and keep hitting it to make the top of its shell keep popping up and hit it under the chin until it dies. Once again I lose my power-ups and head deeper. This time I see that Neith has transformed Athena into a bird. Level 4 is in some sort of temple where the first white wolf barges through me seconds in. The second also passes by very quickly and I miss it too. It's around here I meet the first of the imp enemies. They'll float around above you and then drop down with their hammers. I at least manage to kill the third wolf and get my first power-up around here. After Neith snubs me again, I get my second power-up while having to deal with loads of blobs, but I miss the next one again, so once again, the boss fight is delayed. I get my third power-up right after, which turns me into a tiger. The tiger is the worst transformation in the game, basically if you just made the werewolf bad. You've got weird zigzaggy hadoukens and the flying kick goes up and down, which makes it much more unwieldy. As for the boss, Neith turns into a floating baby crocodile firing miniature suns out of his stomach. I don't get this one either. It also spawns enemies that are just the dragon transformation sprite but shrunken down and painted orange. I mainly just stay crouched firing my fireballs. It starts flashing quite early on, but actually takes forever to die. I lose my power-ups and jump down deeper one more time. The next cutscene shows just how thrilled Neith is over turning Athena into a bird. Final level has me in the underworld being taken on by boxing goat men. As usual by now, I missed the first two wolves in the level while also dealing with unicorn men, weird rolling spiked shellfish, and warthog men in time to miss all three wolves in the first section of a level for the first time. I don't get why it's the huge warthogs who fight with tonfas. It's a good thing I have unlimited lives because missing those wolves is really screwing me over. After missing my chance with Neff again, I just barely manage to get my first power up before it leaves the screen, and soon get my second. Then I get my free one after Neff leaves a second time. The final transformation is the gold werewolf. A bit of a letdown for the final level if I'm honest, the gold isn't even that much different from the regular brown. At least it's a useful transformation this time though. I reach Neff for the final time and he transforms into a big rhino man. Some viewers may recognise him in this form from his cameo in Wreck-It Ralph. He mainly fights by just punching and solar charging me. You can tell you're doing damage as he has this Super Metroid thing going on where he changes colour as he takes damage. This goes much quicker than the last two bosses and I defeat him. Athena flies out of the portal in bird form and returns to her true self. Then the Mega Drive collection itself ruins the moment by interrupting to tell me it's saving. Thanks. Athena doesn't seem to mind that the guy is stuck with a big wolf head as we get a slideshow reminding us of the previous transformations, including a bear propaganda poster. The tiger one even makes it look as pathetic as it feels to play as. It's then revealed the entire game was a film and filming is wrapped up and everyone celebrates with a pint, the end. Altered Beast isn't the most interesting game to play today. It's a little slow and quite often it feels like the enemies have a much bigger advantage when it comes to movement and attack range. But I can still get some enjoyment out of it, especially when you finally get those non-tiger transformations. It's okay. Next up is the Mega Drive version, the one I've played most. Before anything, I have to bring up Zeus's famously bad acting at the beginning with his
"Rise from your grave,"
sounding like Elmer Fudd. There are some graphical downgrades, sprites are smaller and the remains of killed enemies no longer jump out towards the screen. The wolves with power-ups are now blue and no longer flash. Music also took a slight hit, but it's still close enough that you could prefer either soundtrack over the other. Since we're no longer on arcade, there's no need to overwhelm players with enemies to bleed and dry their money, so by default there are less enemies around. This makes the game more manageable and enjoyable to me. But if you need that difficulty, there is a more arcade accurate hard mode. One change is that if you make it to Neff 3 times in a level without being transformed, you'll just have to fight the boss in the state you reached him at, but that never happened to me. Another thing I never knew until playing the game for this recording is that if you game over, you can hold A or whatever you have the Mega Drive A mapped to, and press start to start at the beginning of the level you game overed on. Had I known that, I could have beaten this port years ago. Of course, it's not quite infinite continues like the arcade, you do have to replay the entire level. This did mean I spent quite a while stuck on the fourth boss. However, I managed the final boss without having to start again once. Couch fireball swam in the corner and kick through him as he gets close, repeat until he's dead. The ending starts off the same, but as the Centurion and Athena meet, that's it. I'm instead put in a playable credits sequence. The credits kick my ass. There's a couple little extras too, along with level selects and increasing your lives. Hold all three buttons and down and left at the title screen while pressing start. I can toggle which beasts appear on which level. I didn't do too much with this, but I did learn that the bear destroys the first boss and the wolf is destroyed by the second. But that's about it for the Mega Drive port. I don't know how unpopular this is, but I prefer this version over the arcade original. Not enough to rank them separately though. It's mainly the easier difficulty and the little extra in messing with your transformation order. As I've said, I enjoy this game more than most others, but you can still do much better for beat-em-ups on the Mega Drive. Finally, the Master System port. This one was not recorded with the other two since I didn't own this port until July of 2020. It was done just for this episode. Firstly, the graphics and music took a massive hit for an 8-bit system, as did the gameplay speed. It's so slow. Or I should say, you're so slow. The enemies move much faster than you. The only speed benefit you gain is that you only need two power-ups to reach a beast form. You skip the shirt tear and go straight into huge body tiny head from the first. The third level is cut, so you'd think this game would be at least quicker to finish. But no, this game is almost unplayable. It's so easy to get stunlocked to death in this part. But surely there's a continue trick like in the Mega Drive part. There is, but it has limited uses. On game over, hold up, left and both buttons to start off from where you died. Then you must do this again anti-clockwise across the diagonals. This means you only get 4 continues throughout the entire game, and they aren't enough. I even had to start holding up left at the title screen to increase the amount of health I had just to survive longer. Music really suffered too, by the way. The first level and beast theme made it across, if heavily downgraded. But for some reason the boss fights are in total silence. Instead, what used to be the boss theme becomes the level theme for half the levels in the game. These plus the ending means the soundtrack was slashed down to 4 songs. And considering this port came 2 years after Phantasy Star, which managed to fit in more music than the arcade original had, there's no excuse. I should say that this is one of those games where the soundtrack was of a different quality in Japan thanks to the Mark III's FM sound chip. but neither soundtrack sounds that good to begin with, so I couldn't say one is better over the other. I finally reached the boss on my last life with no extra continues and get stun locked in the corner and wiped out. I was pissed off. Enough so that I managed to make it back to him with 3 lives and a continue left over. The only way I could deal with Neff is just jump and kick through him just slightly from above until he died. In this ending, the hero returns to his normal state and he and Athena just stare at each other. I was quite forgiving with the other two versions of the game, but this was just shit. I've already explained why, so I won't go into it again. All I'll say is that I'm surprised the two Mortal Kombat ports at the bottom of my ranking have been separated already. There is one other port I'd like to do, but I don't have it. As for all the microcomputer ports, I'm still not sure how to handle them for most games. There's just so many and they all have their differences, but the ones for this don't have anything I'd like to cover, so I'm fine ignoring those.